In the last two lectures, we had discussion on complex power, and now we know that the complex power contains all the power informations of a load. The real part of the complex power is the real or average power P. The imaginary part of the complex power is the reactive power Q. The magnitude of the complex power is the apparent power S, and the cosine of its phase angle is the power factor. Now it is a standard practice to represent the apparent power S, the real power P, and the reactive power Q in the form of a triangle known as the power triangle. And this power triangle has four items. The first one is the apparent power S, and it represents the hypotenuse of the triangle, and we know it is measured in volt amperes. The second one is the reactive power Q, and it is representing the perpendicular of the triangle. It is measured in volt ampere reactive. The third one is the real power, and it is representing the base of the triangle, and we know it is measured in watts. And the fourth item, which is the final item, is this angle, which is the power factor angle theta. Now, if two items out of these four items are given, then by using this triangle, we can have the other two items. S is the hypotenuse, and therefore we can say that S will be equal to under root square of P plus square of Q. Square of P plus square of Q. And we know apparent power is equal to the magnitude of the complex power. And from this triangle, the power factor cos theta will be equal to the real power divided by the apparent power. And we can have sine theta as well. It will be equal to the reactive power divided by the apparent power. And tan theta will be equal to the reactive power divided by the real power. The reactive power divided by the real power. So using all these, we can have the remaining two quantities when we have two quantities given. Similar to this triangle, we have impedance triangle as well, and we will see the use of power triangle and impedance triangle in different circuit combinations in the coming lectures. Now moving on to the next point, the apparent power S can lie in the first quadrant. It can lie in the first quadrant. And when it lies in the first quadrant, you can see that the reactive power is positive. And we know when reactive power is positive, this means the load is going to have an inductive nature, and the power factor will lag. The power factor will lag. And when the apparent power lies in the fourth quadrant, then Q will be negative. This means we have capacitive load, and the power factor will be leading. These two points are very important, and the apparent power can also lie in the second and the third quadrants, but when it happens, the real power will be negative, and this means we should have the negative load resistance, and this is only possible when we have active circuits. So remember all these points. I will end this lecture here. See you in the next one.